And we're back with Richard Reviews. Today we are reviewing a book for richardreviews.com/griffinchestnut here on YouTube. Today's book, Richard is here and he will be reviewing for us, is titled Chrome Yellow by Aldous Huxley. This, of course, is the American first version of Chrome Yellow, which was Huxley's, one of his earliest novels to date, which was claimed to be attacked by the Gasser Matun. Inevitably, when it first was released early in his Orbit career. This is Richard's piece. This is his personal piece, which we're going to discuss right now. This piece he keeps pretty close to his heart, as it was not only an introduction to Huxley, but a gateway to the paraphernalia of The Expanse, which Richard holds very highly. This is Richard's personal piece that we're going to talk about. He obtained this piece in the year 2014, which he completed reading the entire piece from front to back, as well as anything else in the spring of that year as well, the spring of 2014. Richard did a lot of outdoor activities, including hiking and a lot of camping in the upper New York region of upstate New York, where it was raining a lot in that spring. It was a rainy spring where Richard did most of his reading in his cabin in the woods. Richard maintained that the area around his cabin, he worked for a committee called the Majestic, and these were residential human beings that held the belief that there should be different types of squads going against the documented government and such, especially originating in the 60s. That was its sole purpose, and Richard sympathizes with the original members, which is why he set out to find this book, and this book gave him more information on that current site. Not only is it a self-help book, but it deliberately changes the course of what you can find based on different types of inauguration, and there's something really successful about it in terms of acupuncture. The attention that it is given to is certainly understandable, but there is a strong business behind the plot of this piece, and that's what Richard holds to his heart. That's what Richard holds to his life. So Richard maintains the fact that he stands by this piece, and ultimately he considers it a very well written piece, a very well documented piece, and he claims it gets two thumbs up. For in Richard's rating system, two thumbs up for Chrome Yellow. Can't really go wrong with this book. He recommends it for the common reader. He recommends it for anybody that wants to get involved in a Huxley version. So people will put generally two different styles of format in this synchronized delectable unity. And that's how he gets into his deep research. And his deep research always follows the pact of first come, first serve, of course, the fully able understood and what is required. And those steps help Richard maintain a fluid conjectivity about the happiness in his dreams, the happiness in his life, and the mindful meditation that he's able to influence others and around him through substances known as LSD and psilocybin mushrooms, which is coming up next in the dreamscape for Richard. It's an amazing piece where you can get influenced heavily by the strong altitude of the specialness in the Sikh. And the Sikh, it brings beautiful light, and it's sort of like being hypnotized, and there's a different form of subconsciousness that Huxley is able to maintain and he's able to affiliate with. And it's a beautiful piece in terms of its participation in its structure. And what Richard means by that is the fact that everything that you think about is chemically influenced by the biomechanical things in the body, ultimately show a grand calcification, or any other side effect, residual effects due to poisoning in the nature environment, brings to Richard's attention this conglomerate conspiracy theory about the fluoride in the water system in the United States of America. Richard is a New York native, and he's done a lot of work in the anthropology line of work in his life. So thankfully we have his experience to document. As for the piece itself, going over the condition and everything that surrounds it, the piece is in very good condition, as you can tell. It's in very good condition. This is Richard's personal piece. It's one of his prized possessions. And it's one of his best works, as you can see. The cover is beautiful, very minimal, substantial. You can tell it's a soft cover. This piece remains a soft cover. And it is a short piece, too, as you can see. But nonetheless, it is a beautiful piece, as we're going to take a look at now. The condition is great. The side, the bottom cream, very good trim. Some small brim here and there, but the trim is very good. Even this side, good trim. Nice clean cut. Good trim, good cut. And this side, good trim and good cut. On the side, we have chrome yellow, ADOS, Huxley, okay? And, of course, on the back, we have our certain praise dedicating the characters and the small synapse of a plot, which is entried into the idea that Huxley was able to formulate to bring into this piece. We have a generic barcode down here. The generic barcode is brought down all the way to the south and then deviated right. Brought down to the south, dilated right. Okay, so this brings back to Richard's theory where this barcode positioning selection is not the greatest. He prefers his barcodes on his pieces a little more north. So we want to round it around somewhere around here, maybe a small push off with the text, and then bring the dilation a little down so you could center it into some sort of a fundamental outpost, whereas you can bend it and bend it back and bend it and bend it back, so it bends too. Okay, and of course the inside, beautiful piece, nothing but gorgeous interiors. Really thoroughly done, beautifully done with the acrylic formulation of this text. As you can see, there is a lot of beautiful imagery and some really genuine pieces dedicated to such a man known as Aldous Huxley. Okay, so that's it for Richard Reviews. We hope you enjoyed Richard Reviews. This has been a Richard Reviews official video. Richard officially gives this piece, Chrome Yellow by Aldous Huxley, a very good review, and he hopes that you talk about it and share this video. That's it for Richard Reviews. Catch us next time here at Richard Reviews.